Thank you. The question is that motion 295 be agreed. Are we all agreed? Oh, of course we're not. That's why members should cast their votes now. Thank you. The vote is now closed. The result of the vote on motion 295 in the name of George Adam is yes 87, no 32, there were no abstentions, and the motion is therefore agreed. The next item of business is consideration of motions 298 to 307 on approval of SSIs, and I ask George Adam on behalf of the Scottish Government to speak to and move these motions.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I hope everyone's sitting comfortably. Then I'll begin. The Health and Protection Coronavirus International Travel Scotland Amendment No. 8 Regulations 2021. This instrument makes further amendments to the Health Protection Coronavirus International Travel Scotland Regulations 2020 and are amended to ensure that if an unaccompanied child travels to Scotland, the child's passenger locator form, if it has not already been submitted, will be provided by the person with responsibility for the child in Scotland as soon as reasonably practical following the child's arrival in Scotland. To require that the person with responsibility in Scotland for the child who was unaccompanied on the journey to Scotland must update the child's passenger information if it becomes inaccurate during the isolation period. To add an offence of contravening the requirement to update the child's information, to extend the requirement for persons who have not undertaken a day 2 test or day 8 test to self-isolate to other persons sharing the premises where the person who has failed to take test is a child, so that the child arriving in Scotland from outside the common travel area or from elsewhere within the common travel area where the child has within the preceding 10 days departed from or transited through on a non-exempt country or territory is required to isolate in a specified premise and not managed accommodation. If unaccompanied by an adult or if the accompanying adult ceases to accompany them prior to travel to the specific premises, all persons with the specified premises where the child isolates are required to isolate, so that the person returning to the boarding schools or Scotland from non-exempt countries can isolate at that boarding school premise. The regulations came into force, Presiding Officer, on the 22nd of March 2021. I'll continue with the next one. The Health Protection Coronavirus Restrictions Requirement Local Level Scotland Amendment No. 19 Regulations 2021. These regulations amend the Health Protection Coronavirus Restrictions and Requirements Local Level Scotland 2020 and are amended as to revoke the requirement to stay at home in a Level 4 area from Friday the 2nd of April 2021 for a person who lives in a Level 4 area must not leave or remain away from that area, to provide an exemption for gathering outdoors in a Level 4 area which is the purpose of organised exercise for persons under 18 years of age. Previously, this only applied to persons under 12 years of age, to expand the list of retailers allowed to open in Level 4 areas, providing that hairdressing and barber services may be provided, with those services provided exclusively by appointment in extended circumstances, to which retail sales may provide by way of click and collect services, to widen the definition of relevant sporting body and senior representative and make a number of consequential amendments in order to provide that an additional group of elite athletes are able to train and compete, to adjust the face covering requirements to make clear that face coverings are required in polling stations or premises where votes are opened and counted unless you have a reasonable excuse, to remove the requirement for a visitor information to be collected if a hospitality venue is being used as a polling station. Presiding Officer, these regulations came into force on the 2nd of April. The Health Protection Coronavirus International Travel Miscellaneous Amendment Scotland Regulation 2021. This instrument makes further amendments to the Health Protection Coronavirus International Travel Scotland Regulations 2020 and are amended to make clearer the scope of testing requirements in Principal Regulations 5C to 5K, to clarify the application of the requirement to self-isolate in specified premises where individuals are not required to enter managed isolation due to their holding a sectoral exemption, to add Bangladesh, Kenya, Pakistan and Philippines to the acute risk countries and territories in Schedule A2, to revoke the prohibition on the arrival of aircraft travelling directly from United Arab Emirates within the Health Protection Coronavirus International Travel Protection on Travel for the United Arab Emirates Scotland Amendments Regulation 2021. Presiding Officer, these regulations came into force on the 9th of April. Next one is the Health Protection Coronavirus Restrictions and Requirements Local Level Scotland Amendment No. 20 Regulations 2021. These regulations amend the Health Protection Coronavirus Restrictions and Requirements Local Level Scotland Regulations 2020 and are amended to adjust the time an outdoor gathering, both in public and in places. Public and places in private gardens, to relax the limit for the number of 4 people for 2 households to those 12, those to a maximum of 6 people from 6 households, and those under 12 continue to be excluded from these limits. To provide that a person who lives in Level 3 or 4 area may provide that area and may leave that area and enter another area, Level 3 or 4 area of Scotland, in order to undertake the outdoor recreation in that area. These regulations came into force on the 16th of April 2021. The Health Protection Coronavirus International Travel Scotland Amendment No. 9 Regulations 2021. This instrument makes further amendments to the Health Protection Coronavirus International Travel Scotland Regulations 2020 and are amended so that a person travelling to Scotland for the purpose of transporting material containing human cells or blood or used in the provision of healthcare by a healthcare provider will be exempt from the requirements to possess a managed self-isolation package and to stay from outside the common travel area where they have in previous 10 days departed from or transited through as an acute risk country or territory. To add India to the acute risk countries and territories in Schedule A2, so that a person must provide the name of the country which issued their passport or travel documents and not the name of the issuing authority, and to add curling world mixed doubles champions to Part 1 of Schedule 3A. And, Presiding Officer, these regulations came into force on the 22nd of April. We have the Health Protection Coronavirus Restrictions and Requirements Local Level Scotland Amendment No. 21, Regulations 2021. These regulations amend the Health Protection Coronavirus Restrictions Requirements Local Level Scotland Regulations 2020 to implement the new Local Protection Levels table that was published on the 13th of April 2021 and moves all part of Scotland currently in Level 4 down to Level 3. These regulations came into force on the 26th of April. The Health Protection Coronavirus Restriction and Requirements Local Level Scotland Amendment No. 22, Regulations 2021. These restrictions amend the Health Protection Coronavirus Restrictions Requirement Local Level Scotland Regulations 2020 to adjust the restrictions on casinos, allowing them to open in Level 2 and applying a curfew in Level 1 and 2. These regulations are to make some further adjustments to remove redundant references and align teen socialising rules with adults in Level 2. Officer, these regulations came into force on May the 5th. The Health Protection Coronavirus International Travel Scotland Amendment No. 10, Regulations 2021. This instrument makes further amendments to the Health Protection Coronavirus International Travel Scotland Regulations 2020 by adding the Maldives, Nepal and Turkey to the acute risk countries and territories in Schedule A2. These regulations came into force on the 12th of May. The next one is, Presiding Officer, the Health Protection Coronavirus International Travel Miscellaneous Amendments Scotland Amendment No. 2, Regulations 2021. This instrument provides further amendments to the Health Protection Coronavirus International Travel Scotland Regulations of 2020 and are amended to extend Regulations 5D to 5G to arrivals in Scotland from exempt countries and territories, requiring that they take a day two test only and adding seasonal agricultural workers to the list of persons to whom Regulations 5D to 5G apply. To require that all persons entering Scotland from a country or territory which is not either an exempt country or territory or acute risk country or territory have not been in the preceding 10 days departed from or transited through an acute risk country or territory are required to stay in specified premises. To require that these travellers entering Scotland under a UK refugee resettlement scheme unaccompanied children or children attending boarding school stay in specified premises if they have entered Scotland from a country or territory which is an acute risk country or territory. So that the requirements to possess a managed self-isolation package and to stay in managed accommodation apply only to travellers arriving in Scotland from acute risk countries or territories or having travelled through an acute risk country or territory in the previous day. To add Australia, Brunei, Faroe Islands, Iceland, Israel and Jerusalem, New Zealand, Portugal and Singapore to the list of exempt countries and territories and Falkland Islands, Gibraltar, St Helena, Ascensions and Tristan da Cunha, South Georgia and the South Sandwich Islands to the list of exempt UK overseas territories in Schedule 1A. To update the passenger notices in Schedule 2 to reflect the latest requirements of travel on health. We're near the end now, Presiding Officer. The Health Protection Coronavirus Restriction and Requirement Local Level Scotland Amendment No. 23, Regulations 2021. These regulations amend the Health Protection Coronavirus Restrictions and Requirements Local Level Scotland Regulations 2020 and are amended to adjust the local allocation across Scotland as a result of the most recent data, to make a minor adjustment to restrictions on hotels and other accommodation to remove references which are no longer required, to adjust the existing power of entry provisions to ensure that they reflect the new position that allows socialising in private dwellings in a greater number and greater numbers and with more households than were previously possible, to adjust the requirements placed on those responsible for business, services and places of worship do not have to ensure physical distancing is maintained between those under the age of 12 and any other individuals, to permit snooker and pool halls and bowling alleys to reopen in Level 2 and allow increased in-home socialising Level 2, to future-proof the travel restrictions in place for level 3 and 4 by reintroducing a 5-mile limit for outdoor exercise and recreation to adjust the restrictions relating to capacity limits in stadia and live events and for public processions in the same levels. These regulations came into force on the 17th of May, Presiding Officer, and that is me. And now I do appreciate the work of the DPLR committee and look forward to them taking up their role again.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Mr Adam. The question on these motions will be put at decision time, and there are 6 questions to be put as a result of today's business. And the first question is that Amendment 278.2 in the name of Liam Kerr, which seeks to amend Motion 278 in the name of Michael Matheson on addressing the climate emergency, be agreed. Are we all agreed? The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we will move to a vote. And the question is that Amendment 278.2 in the name of Liam Kerr, which seeks to amend Motion 278 in the name of Michael Matheson on addressing the climate emergency, be agreed, and members should cast their votes now. The vote is now closed, and I call Christine Graham for a point of order.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. I tried to vote yes, but the thing had just frozen, whatever the thing is.
Thank you, Ms Graham. We'll ensure that your vote is recorded. I call Beatrice Wishart for a point of order.
Presiding Officer, like work for me, and I would have voted yes.
Thank you, Ms Wishart. We'll ensure that's recorded. The result of the vote on Amendment number 278.2 in the name of Liam Kerr is yes, 113, no, 7. There were no abstentions. The amendment is therefore agreed. The next question is that Amendment 278.1 in the name of Monica Lennon, which seeks to amend Motion 278 in the name of Michael Matheson on addressing the climate emergency, be agreed. Are we all agreed? The amendment is therefore agreed. The next question is that Amendment 278.3 in the name of Mark Ruskell, which seeks to amend Motion 278 in the name of Michael Matheson on addressing the climate emergency, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The amendment is therefore agreed. The next question is that Amendment 278.4 in the name of Alex Cole-Hamilton, which seeks to amend Motion 278 in the name of Michael Matheson on addressing the climate emergency, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
No.
The The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we will move to a vote, and members should cast their votes now. The vote is now closed. I call Maggie Chapman for a point of order.
Thanks, Presiding Officer. My vote thing froze. I would have abstained.
Thank you, Ms. Chapman. We'll ensure that's recorded. The result of the vote on amendment number 278.4 in the name of Alex Cole-Hamilton is yes 10, no 89. There were 21 abstentions. The amendment is therefore not agreed. The next question is that motion 278 in the name of Michael Matheson as amended on addressing the climate emergency be agreed. Are we all agreed? The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we will move to a vote, and members should cast their votes now. The vote is now closed, and I call Maggie Chapman for a point of order.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Sorry, everything's frozen. And on this final vote, I would abstain. And if I can correct the record, my previous vote should have been a yes. But abstain on this final vote.
Thank you, Ms. Chapman. We'll record your current vote. We can't change the vote that has occurred, but your comment has been recorded. Thank you. The result of the vote on motion 278 in the name of Michael Matheson as amended is yes 113, No, 1. There were 6 abstentions. The motion, as amended, is therefore agreed. I propose to put a single question on the approval of 10 SSI motions. Does any member object? The final question... The final question is that motions 298 to 307 in the name of George Adam on approval of SSIs be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
That concludes decision time, and there will be a short pause before we move to members' business.